Welcome back to Switch to Linux. So today we are going to have a look at Peppermint OS 10 Respin. Of course, this video is dedicated to the memory of Mark Greaves, who was the lead developer on the project, who very sadly passed away. And I just thought this distribution is just so good, one of the best. In fact, this is the number two distribution I recommend. And I just like the modernicity of Linux Mint a little bit better, but this one here is just absolutely fabulous, and I do run in production on two of my systems are running Peppermint. And I never got the chance to look at Peppermint OS 10 Respin, and so we're going to go ahead and have a look at that today. And so the greatest thing I see in the Peppermint project is how well they've built a community and listened to that community. There's so many changes in here that are the direct result of people saying, we could do this and we can do that. Of course, my favorite, as he said, and I'm not sure if that was serious or whatever else, but he said to me in a live chat, you know, they removed the Dropbox from the setting panel because of my constantly talking about it. Like, the Nemo integration in Dropbox is still there. So if you're using Dropbox and Nemo, you can still use it. But what my criticism has always been in the past is when you uninstall that, it still stays behind in the settings panel. And I consequently don't like Dropbox. That has now been removed. That is epic. And there are so many other little things in this. So what is the update? Well, they have all of the up to December 10th Ubuntu 18.04 package base updates in. They added cursor resizer in as a GUI utility in the settings panel to help with people who need a, you know, more control over the size of the cursors. There is the web browser manager, which is awesome because it does use SSBs and ICE applications. And so this will give you the ability to quickly add other web browsers to use with your SSBs in there as well. There's a few other little changes. They have added Peppermint 6 style in the panel switch profile. So you can actually go back into all of the classic Peppermint, going back to what Peppermint looked like in version 6. If you like the old school look and feel, boom, one button. It goes back to the old stylings, old themes, old everything. And then they have updated icon themes. P7 zip is full out of the box, so that's actually something that is new. They fixed a bug in ICE applications. I think I need to upgrade to this because since I updated my Peppermint computer, which is not on Respin, it's just on 10, I have had this bug affecting my system, so I need to push the updates, apply to that. Fixed unattended upgrades to work properly. The advertiser blocker now includes more host file block options. Replaced a few SSBs, added a few SSBs and things like that. So absolutely overall, Peppermint OS is definitely one of my favorite distributions and has been for a long time. In fact, where I use this in production, I use it on two systems. One is my banking system because it has the ICE applications and the SSBs out of the box already configured, which basically means that my banking system can run in a very secure environment on a fully encrypted Peppermint install. And that's where I'm using Peppermint right now. The other place is actually all of my books are written on a Peppermint computer. So this is my Lenovo S21e computer, really low spec, so Linux Mint would not work very well on it. And with that build, I wanted to go with something a little bit more lightweight. So, you know, I could do MX Linux, I could do Linux Lite, there's a few other options. Of all of the ones that I looked at, absolutely Peppermint was the best. So that's why I use Peppermint in actual production. It's probably the number two distro that I recommend right behind Linux Mint. So with that, let's go ahead and have a look at what the desktop looks like. So here we are on the Peppermint desktop. The only thing I did here is I installed it and I ran the updates. This is a very nice mishmash of all of the best of the different things. It's not like some distros that will take all the worst of different things and put them together. Here we have a combination of LXDE, we have a combination of XFCE. There's a lot of Mint applications, like the Mint Update Manager is absolutely one of the best implementations for update managers, in my opinion. Here's kernel updater. You can actually, if I go ahead and refresh it, so it should say everything's up to date. I went ahead and installed updates shortly before the video. So here, everything is up to date. Update Manager is just very nice, works very well directly out of the box. We also, though, have a lot of other features. Very low memory, of course. It's running on, 388 megabytes of RAM, which is very nice, and it runs extraordinarily snappy, even on my little... And I don't remember if my little writing computer is a single core or dual core, but it has 2 gigs of RAM. This system runs perfectly out of the box. Oh, look at that. It's telling us we have an update. Oh, really? We have an update. All right, sure. Let's go ahead and install an update there. So that shouldn't take long to do. Just go ahead and install that little 6 kilobyte update. And let it do its thing, and then we should be all good to go and fully up to date. Now, the other thing that we have is Peppermint does give us an individual, very nice GUI settings panel. This is where you'll notice that the Dropbox option is no longer here in the settings. It is actually still installed by default, so this will still continue to work with Dropbox on default. It's just not in the settings panel anymore, and that was really cool. So we have our Peppermint Control Center here. This is where we're running our themes. So if you do want to go back, I believe this is where our themes are. So let's go ahead and see if this is where they're at. It may not be in this menu. It may be in another one. Yeah, I think it's in a different menu there. But anyway, somewhere on here, there is the fast ability to jump back to the old Peppermint, unless I missed it. You know, when you're doing a live show like this, you do sometimes miss stuff that's right in front of your face, you know. But anyway, we have our keyboard, so you can increase, decrease your accelerations on your keyboards and pointers. Desktop effects, you can adjust your panels and things. We have all those. Of course, they have added more recently the right click and customize, so you can add your desktop icons. This is something that you used to have to do through the decon editor. It was another one of my early criticisms. Never enough to make it to not like the system, but they add this little stuff in here because of the community feedback, and that is just so important. Okay, so here's some more themes here. Let's go back and see if... I think this actually is where it is. I just don't remember the exact name of the one. So Arc Red Dark is the one we were at. So you could do like a Redmond. You could do a Thin Ice. I find there... Most of them are pretty ugly there. There we go. So we'll stick with that color theme there. All right, so we'll close that guy out. We have panel preferences. And if I remember, I think this is actually where it was. So here it is. So you can go ahead and I think you double click on this and it's going to give you, what was it? Import, export, apply. There you go. All right, so now when you apply the configuration, now you have the old school. So you can go ahead and change your panel between different versions that you have. Here's a Redmond. Just so many cool, nice little options that we have. I do actually like the Peppermint 10 these days the best. There's a few customizations that I generally do to it, but it's good. Here's our colorizing our folders and things. So you can go ahead and do some adjustments if you want to make direct, you know, very distinct changes to the color and style. Some of the best artwork ever is found within this. Of course, this is actually the one that I run on my writing computer. That's the one that I use. I do like some of these other artwork. It's just fabulous, fabulous stuff. Let's go ahead and finish our distro with review with this one here. All right, so inside of our tweaks, here is something else that is new, is they've added more options to this. There used to only be 4 options. Now we have, what do we have? It looks like we have 6 options. So we've added a few more options. So these are going to add a lot of lines to your host file directly to block advertising services right out of the box. Very nice. Reset panel to defaults. If you mess something up, I have no idea how to fix it. Click on this guy there. It's just going to reset everything back to you. Browser manager. I've not looked at the browser manager here. All right, so here we can install Firefox is already installed. We can install Chrome, Vivaldi, Chromium. So I believe that Chrome, Vivaldi, and Chromium might be the ones that will work with ICE applications. So Chrome, Chromium, Vivaldi, and Firefox. And then you can create it with its own isolated browser profile. Firefox always isolates the browser profiles, just an FYI. But if you want to go ahead and install like Vivaldi, you can just go ahead and click it there without having to go in and do anything else. So that is an amazing brand new tool in this latest version here. Here's your cursor resizer, so you can go ahead and make some adjustments. I've not used this before, so we're just going to go ahead and test it out. I'm not sure if this is downloading and installing Vivaldi or if it's messing with our cursor size. Okay, so there you go. You can see now our cursor is bigger. So you can go in and there you go. Vivaldi is successfully installed. Go down and make adjustments to our cursor like that. Let's go ahead and have a look in our internet menu, and there is Vivaldi. So now we have Vivaldi. Software settings updaters. Here's a font setting DPI. So if you want to change the font size, you can go ahead and do that. Very easy. It does tell you what that default is, which is totally awesome. So if you want to go back, you can go ahead and do that. Hardware additional drivers is going to be if you are fighting with individual hardware, go ahead and run that. Network tools, we have our ICE applications up here, sharing, and basic system stuff. So very, very nice, easy to use distribution. This is absolutely one of my favorites for all these reasons. It's just easy to use. It's also de-bloated. So if we look into here, instead of installing a lot of extra applications, what they actually do is these are all ICE applications. So it does not actually have Microsoft products or Google products installed on the system. These are all ICE applications, which means that when you click on one of these, it's just going to open up an isolated web browser profile. And that isolated web browser profile is going to come in here and just load up this guy. And if you were to sign in with Google here, it's going to keep this isolated from your standard web browsing. So this is a way that you can keep logged into Google on your SSBs without Google having access to everything else that you're doing on the rest of your system. So that is definitely a good thing to do. Now, if you're like, well, I don't really even want any of that, you can just head on over to the ICE application menu over here, find remove, and just remove all of these things that you want to get rid of. So let's say if you don't want the Microsoft products. Now, all of these games here, these are all, again, ICE applications. So you can just go ahead and do these, and you can add your own. All you're going to do is come over to the Create, give it a name, give it a web address, tell it where it should be at in the menu, and then you can either select an icon from the computer or use the site favicon. And then once you do that, if you do want a desktop or a panel, you can right-click, add to the desktop, right-click, add to the panel. That's going to add the panel over here. You're going to have to move it. Bing, there you go. Now you have it moved over there to the other side. So that's, I mean, this is why I love Peppermint. It's just absolutely one of the best distributions. I do like some of the modern elements in Linux Mint Cinnamon, which is why I do use that one a little bit more. But if you're looking at needing a distribution, particularly for a lighter weight system, or if you need a computer that is lighter weight on the system for more intense applications, Peppermint is absolutely the way to go. They have routinely and consistently listened to the community. They have given us one of the best distributions ever. And in all frankness, I think that the Peppermint Project deserves some of the greatest kudos of all of the projects out there. So let me know your thoughts on Peppermint in the comments down below.